All right, we're going to return to Atlanta, Judy, in that Senate race to replace retiring Republican Saxby Chambliss. We're joined once more tonight by Celeste Headlee of Georgia Public Broadcasting. So is there the possibility here that this race could turn into a runoff?
Actually, right now, it's looking like with at least 80% of counties reporting that David Perdue has 57% of the vote and Michelle Nunn has 41%. Obviously, as you probably know, that's far off of what the polls predicted. So if that ends up being a final total, there's going to be some questions asked in Georgia.
Okay. And how much there was actually a third candidate that we didn't actually mention earlier this evening, wasn't campaigning, Amanda Swafford. Did she have an impact in this at all?
Not that we're seeing so far. She's often been less than 2% of the vote of reporting. That was predicted, though, as people saw that the race was very, very close. Many people predicted that those who said they were going to vote for the third-party candidate would actually switch their vote over to the Republican because they were nervous that the Republican might lose.
Okay, how much have the candidates focused on some of those big national issues, especially unemployment? Georgia has one of the highest unemployment rates, if not the highest, in the country.
It is the highest at this point. David Perdue certainly has tried to make this a race on national politics, and he hasn't been shy about admitting that. He's tried to make this race about Harry Reid and Barack Obama. Michelle Nunn, understandably, has tried to distance herself from the White House as much as possible. Barack Obama has a 42% approval rating here in Georgia. However, I think when most of our reporters, at least, have spoken to voters at the polls, the things that they've mentioned as being important to them have been the economy, the unemployment rate, as you mentioned, and education in this state. Not many people have mentioned the president or Harry Reid at all when they've gone to the polls today.
Okay. And where are we with the governor's race? While I've got you, I mean, did we see people cross over and switch parties voting for different candidates for different races?
No, it looks like that so far the results are showing the people voting exactly on party lines, meaning that all night long we've seen the exact same percentage of people voting for both Nathan Deal and David Perdue, the two Republican candidates, and the same number of people voting for the two Democrats as well, Michelle Nunn and Jason Carter. So this looks to be a race on turnout, how many voters each party can get to the polls rather than necessarily the individual candidates.
All right, Celeste Headlee of Georgia Public Broadcasting joining us. Thanks so much for your time.